This is totally my favorite pedal out of my whole pedal board. It can do everything. It's a whole bunch of pedals in one, and it's just the best. And I'm going to show you everything it does. Keep watching. All right, here is the VE20. Since it can do so many different effects, we're just going to talk about a few of them. The ones that I want to go over are the reverb level, the harmonizer effect, the distortion, flanger, strobe, and the looping capabilities. First is the reverb level. There's a whole button for reverb right here on the VE20. If I just press it, it will give me a scale from 0 to 100. I'm going to put it at about 60 just for in this video so you can hear the effects a little bit better. But if you turn it all the way up to 100, it'll be almost like a cathedral. Let me show you that real quick. 100. Now, the first effect that I want to show you is the harmonizer. This is a really cool tool that vocalists use a lot, but we can use it with the flute and it creates chords for us. It can create all sorts of different intervals. This is one that I use a lot, the third and the lower fifth. You get a whole chord with the flute, and it's awesome to have that lower fifth because we are always playing high notes. So having that low fifth really adds a lot to the sound. Now when you're performing, and if you want to turn that effect off briefly, all you have to do is hit this pedal right here. It says harmony. So if I turn this off, it will no longer harmonize. The distortion effect on the VE20 is really easy to use. Once you've selected distortion from the presets, we're going to go in and edit some of the settings. So I'm going to press menu and go over to tone and effects, distortion, and now you have two choices. You can change drive and tone. Drive is basically how much distortion you want. Zero is basically no distortion at all. And if we're going to turn it up all the way to 100, it's going to be totally overdriven. I'm going to turn that down because it's a little bit too much, but just so you guys can see what that does. And now, for tone, you can go from negative 50 up to positive 50. If you go to the negatives, you're going to be emphasizing the lower harmonics of the sound. It's going to make a different timbre. And the upper, the positives, is going to be emphasizing the higher harmonics in the sound. So here is at negative 50, and it's going to be a more mellow timbre. And I'll turn it up to positive 50 just for comparison. The next effect that I want to talk about is called flanger. This is an effect I've never talked about in any of my videos. And again, you can buy a separate stomp box for this effect, but since it's included in the VE20, this is what I use. Now, flanger creates a sort of watery effect on the sound. It's kind of like a special effect, if you will. Again, I just use this to make different tone colors, different interesting sounds. And again, you can go in here and alter the parameters for the effect. Right here is flanger. You can tell it how fast you want the watery effect to be going. Again, from 0 to 100. Let me turn it all the way up just as an experiment. Now the next special effect I want to talk about is called strobe. Strobe, just like a strobe light. And like the name suggests, it kind of has flashes of the sound that are just like a strobe light. There's no better way to explain it. So what I'm going to do is make sure that this is turned all the way up so you can really hear the effect. Okay, it's already at 100. And I'm also going to turn on my delay pedal so you can really hear the echo with the strobe effect. Now, we've talked about a lot of different things on the VE20, but I still haven't shown you the coolest thing about it, and that is the looping function. Now, when you loop something, what that means is that you're recording a few seconds or a few measures of music into the VE20, and then when you tell it to stop recording, it keeps replaying those couple of measures that you told it to record over and over again. And you can do several different layers of this looping. So let me just show you what it does, because it'll make a lot more sense once I show you. Now, I haven't done anything with this left pedal over here yet in this video, and we're about to use it for looping. Now, the looping function is turned on by this little button right here. It says phrase loop. I'm going to turn it on. Now, what you do is we're going to hit the pedal one time, and you got to start playing right when you hit the pedal, otherwise there's going to be a gap. So as soon as you hit the pedal, you start playing, and as soon as you hit the pedal again, it's going to stop recording, and it's going to start playing whatever it was that you just had been playing. So what I'm going to do is record a basic loop, and then I'm going to record a couple of other things on top just so you can hear how it works. And what you do with a loop is you can kind of create a whole ensemble by yourself. It takes a little bit of time to get the loops started, but once you do, you can kind of solo on top, and it's just a really great tool. So here we go. Let me try making a couple loops for you guys. Alright, this is playing on its own now. This is just a loop. I'm not playing. It's just recording. Playing my recording. So I'm going to add another loop on top. Just going to press the pedal once, and it's going to record. Press the pedal again, it's going to stop. So there you go, you can see a little sample of it. If you want to stop it, all you got to do is tap this pedal twice. And there you go, that's looping on the VE20. All right, that's all we're going to talk about in this video with the VE20 Vocal Effects Processor. Thank you for watching this video. Please subscribe to my channel, Sonic TV. I'm always uploading new videos showing you how to play the electric flute, all the equipment I use, everything. It's all here. Please let me know if you have any questions about anything that I'm doing. I love hearing from you and love hearing what you're creating yourself. Thanks for watching.